A very good morning to you, dear students. I suppose most of you have siblings, either a brother or a sister, or maybe both. The bond with your sibling is always special, isn't it? You play, laugh, make fun of each other, share your secrets with each other, and so on. However, many of you will relate to these kind of images. Yes, a fight or an argument with your sibling. Isn't it very common between you and your siblings? Of course, you will agree with this. Sometimes we fight, argue, or quarrel with one another over petty issues or small things, and it automatically becomes a very big scene. But the beautiful part of this bond of siblings is that no matter what the fight was all about, but by the end of the day, we all sort out our issues with our siblings, hence making our bonds even more stronger. Today, we will learn a similar poem of an argument between the poetess and her brother, titled "The Quarrel" by Eleanor Fajon. Eleanor Fajon was a very famous children's book writer. She wrote various plays, poetry, biography, history, and satire. Now let us read the poem. I quarreled with my brother. I don't know what about. One thing led to another, and somehow we fell out. The start of it was slight. The end of it was strong. He said he was in the right. I knew he was in the wrong. We hated one another. The afternoon turned black. Then suddenly my brother thumped me on the back and said, "Oh, come along. We can't go on all night." I was in the wrong, so he was in the right. The first four lines of the poem tell us about a quarrel that took place between the poetess and her brother. They do not know what it was all about or why did it start. But one thing led to another. One issue cropped up and that kept going on. And somehow they fell out, which simply means that they stopped talking to each other. The start of this quarrel was slight. That means it started for a very small reason, but the end of it was strong, wherein they actually stopped talking to each other. Isn't it very common between all of us? Yes, we do start on petty issues and continue the fight till it becomes much worse, and then we automatically stop talking to each other. He said he was in the right. He kept arguing, the poetess brother kept arguing that he was right. But the poetess knew that he wasn't the one who was right. Actually, he was wrong. They hated one another. They did not want to look at each other's faces. The afternoon, she says, turned black. Did it really turn black? No, it just turned so boring. Because the brother-sister just did not speak to each other. They did not make fun with each other. Doesn't the same thing happen to us when we don't speak to our siblings? We too feel bored and irritated. We feel annoyed that we are not speaking to each other. We just want to get back to normal with each other. Then suddenly the poetess brother came and thumped her on the back. He just petted her. He said that they couldn't go along like this all night. They had to make up for the fight now and start back to normal. He said he was in the wrong. But with this kind of behavior of his, that he resolved the fight all by himself, his behavior was actually in the right. The message that we derive from the poem is that no matter what the quarrel is about, we should quickly resolve it and bounce back to normal, or else it will just strain our relationships forever. Children, hoping that you have understood and enjoyed the poem well. Thank you, students, and have a lovely day ahead.